Okay, so now today we want to learn the normalization. Okay, normalization is known to you. We used to have the min-max normalization. We used to have the z-score normalization, right? And we are learning VECA in our subject, that is data mining 3160714. Okay. Normalization concept we already know. Now what we want to know is we want to use it with VECA. For installing the VECA, you can always refer to, say, Google. In that you can search for VECA, VECA download. Then after we can say that here is a link. You can click on that. So you'll be having the VECA page where you can click on the download. So now here we are having the options available, that is for Windows, then we can say for macOS, for Linux, for other platforms, right? So you can download according to your operating system and you can install that. Okay, so after that, here I'm having Windows and I'm opening my VECA. So click on VECA, it is this one, right? So I'm opening that. Now we can see here the Explorer is there, right? So we are clicking on that. What is our aim? Our aim is to have the normalization, right? For normalization, we want to use the min-max normalization, and second one is the z-score normalization, right? Okay. Now, what we have to do with this one, that is VECA Explorer, first of all, we have to open the data set. Here, VECA is already having few files that has the data, and that is of type ARFF. You can see, but for your own projects, you have already selected the CSV file. No issue for that. You can open the CSV file also. No issue, fine. So what we want to do is, this dealing with the missing data that was already given to you, right? You can see the recordings are already there on YouTube channel. It is uploaded, fine. So that was for pre-processing, and second one was for the transformation, okay? Now we want to know about the normalization. For that, what should be there? That is, yeah, and again saying you that you have to show each and every process of using this VECA. For example, today we are learning normalization. So what you have to do is you have to open the file. This opening. Now here, this is Windows and my installation folder is C colon program files VECA 3-8-5 and in data, right? This is the VECA's data directory, okay? Now here we can say many data files are there. Just now we are selecting say weather numeric ARFF, right? This we are opening here, selected, now clicking on open, right? You can say, but our file is different. No issue. You can select from here CSV, right? That is available. And then after, whatever is your path, you can select from here. And then after, you'll be able to open your CSV file. Okay, so no issue for that. Just now we can say we are opening this file, that is weather numeric ARFF. Clicking on open, so it will open the file. Now, what is available here? It shows relation, that is weather, attributes 5. We can see the attributes here. The title is that is attributes, right? Outlook temperature, humidity, windy, play, right? 14 instances are there, 14 weights is there, right? So each and every instance is having weight is equal to 1. Then here the selected attribute is outlook. So for that it shows missing, then the label and the count for that particular attribute, fine? And the type of it is nominal. This we already know, right? Okay. So for each and every attribute, we can see what it is giving us this detail. Name, missing, distinct, type, numeric or nominal or whatever, right? So, and for this particular data set, here we are having the visualization, right? For visualization, we can click on visualize all. It will display for all attributes. Let's see that. This is the visualization of all the attributes. Fine. So closing this. Now, what to do? Now, whatever we want to apply, that is just now we are interested in doing the normalization. Okay. So that we can choose from this filter. Okay. So let me show you that for mean max normalization, we can use the normalize filter where it is available. That is available in unsupervised attribute. Let me show you that where it is. It's here. Now, this is Weka Explorer. Choose filter, right? Choose filter. Now, filters. Now, unsupervised attribute. And here, we want to have what? That is normalize, right? Here it is there, normalize. So, what it says? Normalize all numeric values in the given data set, right? We can click our mouse on this, we'll be able to see the description for it. Okay, so what do we want to do is, here we are having, say, scale and translation. Two things are there. Let me show you, you can have the idea. And by default, resulting values are values are in normalize. Yeah, they are there in the 0 to 1 range. But if we want to change that, then we have to change the scale and translation parameter. Let me show you that. That is, if we want to have the minus 1 to 1 range, then we should use scale is equal to 2 and translation is equal to minus 1, right? So we'll be able to get the range from minus 1 to 1. Translation is what? Translation is the starting minimum value, right? And scale is equal to 2, that means, is it the maximum value for min max? No, it is not so. It is for the difference of max and mean, right? Let me show you, you can have the idea. Here I am clicking on this normalize filter, right? Okay, normalize filter we are able to see here, fine? Now click on this. So what we'll be able to see is normalize all numeric values in the given data set, fine? Okay. Now here we can see here it is scale is equal to 1.0 and translation as 0.0. That means we can say just now by default the range is 0 to 1. Where we want to convert our data. We know that for mean max normalization, we are having the data which is there in the range that is minimum and maximum, and there we want to convert to a new range, that is the new range. For this particular filter, we can see that we are having 0 to 1 range by default, right? So I am not changing. As I told you that we are having two parameters setting. Translation is the starting value and scale is the difference. That is the mean and max difference. Okay, so this is 0 and 1. So we can say that the range is 0 to 1 only. Fine, let me select that. Okay. Now, let us see the data. How we can see the data? We can see the data using edit. That is, we can click here. This is edit, right? Here we'll be able to see the data. That is, we can say sunny, overcast. Here you can find the values. This is temperature, which is of the type numeric. Humidity, which is of the type numeric, right? These things are known to you, fine? We are looking at the data which is available. 85, 83, 80, right? These are the data available. This is also numeric, fine? Okay. For normalization, we know that we are having the numeric range, isn't it? Already data is having its mean and max, and we are providing a new range to which we want to transform our data, fine? So let me close this and let's see what is the minimum and maximum for this particular temperature. Minimum is 64, maximum is 85 for this attribute, that is temperature, fine? Okay, for other variables also, we can say this minimum is 65, for maximum this is 96. Now we want to apply this normalization filter. Now data we have seen, right? That is using edit. Minimum and maximum also we have seen by clicking a particular attribute. And here the statistic will be able to see, that is minimum, maximum, mean, standard deviation. Fine. For humidity also we have seen that. Right, it is having some values, fine. Windy, do we have? No, it is nominal. Play, is it having something? No, it is nominal, right? Outlook, that is also nominal, fine. So temperature and humidity, both are numeric. To that only we can normalize, isn't it? So now let us do the apply. We have only selected the filter, we haven't yet applied it, right? So let us apply that. Now what happens here? The visualization is changed, but we should see the data, isn't it? Let me see the temperature. Here minimum is changed 0 to 1. Minimum is 0 and maximum is 1. It was not this, right? It was 64, 85 or something like that. It was not 0, 1, right? It was more than that, isn't it? Let me check for this humidity. It is also in the range of 0 to 1. But let's see the data, isn't it? Whatever is being modified. So let us see edit. We can see the data is being changed here, right? It is normalized. Yes, we can see the normalized data here. Fine. Okay, and that is according to the min-max normalization. Fine. Min-max normalization formula is already known to you. In case if you do not remember, let me show you that here. Let me show you min-max normalization. Yeah, here it is. This is the formula. We already know the formula, right? It is V dash is equal to V minus mean A upon max A minus mean A into max, which one? New max A minus new min A plus new min A, right? So this we already have studied, fine. Here we are applying that using Weka. So that's what we have seen, fine. In the edit also we have seen the data is getting changed and now it is in the range that is from 0 to 1, right? We can see here minimum and maximum, fine. If we want to change that range, we can change it in the scale and translation, right? We already seen that, fine. So you can set that value and you can have the min max normalization, fine. Okay, now which filter we have used for that? We have used the normalized filter, isn't it? We have used the normalized filter for that, okay. Now this also you should keep it in your mind, that is translation is zero and scale is the difference between the mean and max. And for this example, by default, whatever was there, that only we have taken, that is 0 and 1. If you want to change it, what should we do? We should change these values, right? In this, we see this here. Here, this is, say, minus 1. So that is the starting value. And what about the scale? If I do it this way, 2, that means what? What should be there? Minus 1 is starting value, plus 2. So that will be 1. So minus 1 to 1, if I want to set, I can use it this way, right? Let me apply this filter, right? If you want to apply on your original data, then you should load the original data, right? So what you can do is whatever you have applied just now, that you can undo and then after you can apply the filter. Or otherwise, you can close this. You can close this. Say, let me close this. Close the window, fine? So what I'll be having is, again, open the Explorer. Open the file. C drive, program files, say Weka folder, data folder, then within numeric ARFF, right, and open. So this is original file, right? Because we have closed that, we haven't saved. See, saving the data will not change the original file. Right, it will. How we will save, I'll show you. Just wait for some time. What we are doing is for temperature. Now see, the original data was there, that is minimum is 64, maximum is 85, right? Now what I do is choose filters, unsupervised attribute, and then in that we are having the normalize, right? We are having normalize. So if we want to get it in the range of minus 1 to plus 1, we can have the scale as 2.0 and translation as minus 1.0, right? So let me select this. This is normalize, right? What is the scale and translation by default for the filter, that is 1 and 0. What I want is, I want to have the data in the range of minus 1 to 1. So, minus 1, that is the translation we have to write here. Minus 1 and scale. Scale is not the last value, but it is the difference. So, if I want plus 1, then we should have minus 1 plus 2, that will be plus 1, right? So we can have translation as minus 1 and scale as 2 or 2.0, whatever, right? Okay, So let us do it as okay. Have we applied the filter? No, we haven't. So before that, whatever data is there, we should check it out. Add it. So this is original data, right? Because we have opened the Explorer and we have seen the data, right? So close this. Now, what should we do is we should apply the filter, right? The setting we have already done for normalized filter. Now we apply it, right? Now, what is that in the data? But temperature. What is minimum? -1. What is maximum? +1. What is for humidity? It is having -1 as minimum and +1 as maximum, right? Now, we have applied and we have seen that, right? We can see, edit and see the data. You can see that it is in the range of -1 to +1, fine? Okay, this +1 is there and this is -1 is there, right? So it's minimum and maximum range is there. Okay, so this is what is min-max normalization. It's very simple, isn't it? So now I want to save this data and then I want to apply something. So over there I can do save. So will we replace this file? No, we will not replace this file. This result I'll be sharing, I'll be saving in other file. That is, we can say normalize, and that also I'll not save in this data, but I will save it in any other directory. Like I may be having, say, my own folder, or here I'll be making my own folder, and then I can save in that. Okay, whatever is writable folder, there you can write it. Okay, so there you can save this. Now, as you already know, whatever is the visualization before applying the filter, after applying the filter, and whatever process we follow, for all of them, you have to put the screenshots in your file, fine? So this is about the min-max normalization. Now, the next one is the Z-score normalization. And for that, we need to use the standardized filter. Okay, we need to use the standardized filter. Let's see that. Now, if I do not want to load the file again, what I can do is I can do undo. There are ways to do the things, right? You have done the normalization and then after you have saved your data, right? Now, again, you want to have your original data to apply any other filter, isn't it? So for that, I can be doing undo. What I should check it out is for, say, temperature, what was the data? Is it having? No, it is -1 to 1. So let me undo that. Now let us check it out. Is it having that data? No. Still we have to do the undo. Now check it out. Yes. Now it is having, say, 64 and 85, which was there in original data. And if you do not want to do undo and how many times you should do or what, if you do not remember, no issue. Just close this and load the data again, right? So it will come from the original file only. So clicking on Explorer, open the file. Which file we have used? That was the weather numeric ARFM, right? Weka data, and we can say weather numeric ARFM, right? This file is available and original data, right? Because whatever is the data in the file, that only we have loaded here, right? So now what do we want to do is we want to apply the Z score filter. So for that data, we should check it out. Okay, always for putting the things in your file, first of all, see your original data. You can take the screenshot of it. Then after, we can choose the filter. You can have the visualize all, so you can take this screenshot, put it in the file, then choose the filter, right? Choose the filter, filters, unsupervised, attribute. And now what we want to apply is standardized filter. Where it is? Here it is, right? Standardized filter standardizes all numeric attributes in the given data set to have zero mean and unit variance. We know that for Z-score, we are having zero mean and unit variance, right? This is known to us. So that is for the Z-score, okay? So we can select that. Standardize. Let me choose that. As I want to show you the description, it is having that, or otherwise we can directly choose it. No need to worry for that. It is standardized, right? Okay, standardized filter is being used here, right? Click on that. What it says, standardizes all numeric attributes in the given data set to have zero mean and unit variance, fine? Okay, so these things are there. Okay, now what? We should apply the filter, isn't it? Do we have to set anything here? No, we do not have to set anything here. We have just chosen the standardized filter, and now we should apply that. Already we have seen the data before applying the filter. We have already taken the visualization screenshot also, right, for putting in the file. Okay, so now I'm applying this, and before that I'm checking that temperature is having minimum, maximum, mean and standard deviation, right? These values I'm looking at. So when I apply the filter, I'll be able to see the change, right? For this humidity also, you can take the screenshot of it. So after applying the filter, whatever changes are there, that also you can see and show, fine? Okay, so apply the filter. Now, visualization is getting changed, fine. But say for temperature, what will be having? It was in positive integers, but just now it is -1.456. And maximum is 1.739. So is it converting the data in the range of -2 to +2? No. This is Z score, right? Z score is having mean as 0 and variance as 1, right? So that's what we should check it out. We are not concentrating on this because we do not have that range. For mean max normalization, we do have that range available, that whatever is the older min max and whatever is the newer min max. But for Z score, we should have mean as 0 and standard deviation as 1. Let me check it out for humidity. For this also we can say mean is 0 and standard deviation is 1, right? Okay, so this way we have applied the standardized, that is Z-score filter, fine? Now, before applying the filter, we have seen the data. Now, after applying the filter also, let us see the data, right? We can see the data is getting changed, right? It will not change for nominal data, but it will change for the numeric data, isn't it? So we are able to see the change in these two columns, that they are the temperature and humidity. Okay, now we should again do the visualize all. So we'll be able to see the change, fine. Where we'll be able to see the change? In temperature and humidity, because these two are only the, what we can say? It is the numeric attributes, fine? Okay, so this is what we are able to see, fine? If we want to save it, we can save it, save. You can see we were having the CSV file, so we want to save in CSV only. Okay, you can select that, select it as CSV and give the name accordingly. Save wherever you are having your own folder, right? I'm not saving because I'm not having that, and just now I do not want to have it in CSV, okay? So I'll not do that, but I have shown you the way and you can do that, fine? So now I want to do something else. So for that, I'll again close this. So yes, so now if I want to have the file open and whatever data is there only on that I want to apply anything else, like say classification, clustering, or whatsoever things, then I'll be doing this way, fine? This is known to you now. Either you can do undo, or otherwise you can close it and open it again in the way that you will be able to open through Explorer, open file, so original file will come to you, original data set will come to you, isn't it? So that is all about the normalization.